Hello learners, we are listening Physical Education and Yoga, Lesson 1, Part 1, Introduction to Historical Development of Physical Education. Let's understand the term physical education and its development. You must be aware that physical education and sports is the need of the hour. The objectives of this chapter are to explain the meaning and importance of physical education. Also, to explain the historical development of physical education. Dear learners, it has now become inevitable to live without a culture of physical activity and sports. Physical education has thus become a focal point. Two words, physical, which means bodily characteristics, and education, which means learning for life, combine to coin the term physical education. Physical education is a science of complete development of the individual by participating in physical activities and sports. Physical education is defined by Bucher as an educational process that uses physical activity as a means to help individuals acquire skills, fitness, knowledge and attitudes that contribute to their optimal development as well-being. Learners, now we will learn the importance of physical education. There are various importance of physical education. You can see the aspects in the image being shown on your screen. The first aspect, physical growth and development. Physical activity is a necessary step to develop the proper function and growth of the human body. Optimum development, physical education helps to improve physical, mental, social, and emotional development by participating in physical activities. Intellectual development. A player needs to take decision in different conditions and situations. That ability will help him to improve the insight of thinking. Emotional development. Physical education and sports provides opportunities to control emotions. Haven't you played any time to control your emotions? Is it true? Answer yourself. Social adjustment. Physical activities also provide opportunity of interaction between participation and others in varied situations, enabling them to learn social qualities like sportsmanship, cooperation, honesty, etc. I'm sure you must have friends with whom you enjoy playing. Physical fitness, another virtue. It develops the scientific mode of exercise and knowledge about one's body and its requirement, which contribute immensely to physical fitness. Perfect and scientific training helps to improve the physical fitness of an individual. Do you run every day, boys? The personal adjustment. Physical education gives a full and worthwhile experience to the individual who will help to realize fullest self-expression and highest satisfaction from the result of his action, and thereby facilitates his personal adjustment in life. Another importance, character development, group efforts, loyalty, dedication, discipline, determination will help to build a good character of the individual. Mental development, another important aspect. The physical activities also help to improve the mental development of the individual. Sportsmen take quick decisions on play field, which is an example of mental development. Neuromuscular development. Nothing happens until the body is coordinated itself, and neuromuscular coordination develops well only when its various types of skills and exercises are done repeatedly for a long time. For doing a thing accurately or learning new skills, a good neuromuscular coordination is indispensable. Constructive use of leisure time. We all play a lot, but physical education contributes to the constructive use of leisure time. Leisure time is an important so that the child gets the chance to indulge in social activities, engaging himself or herself in a variety of activities. Economic value. Sports and games provide opportunity to engage in activities which provide opportunity for making One, a business out of sport, having a lot of economic value. We come to the next aspect, an important aspect, which is physical education and its historical development. The history, which is divided into following ages, the Vedic age, the epic age, the historical age, the Nalanda period, the Rajput period, the Muslim period, and the British period, and the post-independence period, which is 1947 upwards. The Vedic age. This age had a lot of activities in it, including archery, horse riding, chariot racing. They were the common sports available in the Vedic age. In fact, these sports were not meant for pleasure only. They were devices of war as well. Yoga seems to have originated during this period. Pranayama was considered a sacred duty. Some of the physical exercises also included Surya Namaskar. In the epic age, the exploits of the Indians of this period can be gathered from the Ramayana and the Mahabharata, which were composed during this period. Both epics reveal that this period was a period of great turmoil and wars. Bhishma, Drona, etc. have become immortal for their valor. The historical ages. The ancient religion of the Hindus had its first jolt in this period. During emphasis was given to physical training, referred to a very elaborate system of physical training for the army. Wrestling, sword fighting, javelin throwing, horse racing, etc. were a common sport in those days. Training in the art was both for intensive and extensive support. The Nalanda period. Nalanda was a great city of learning where more than 6,000 students, not only from different parts of the country, but also from foreign lands, used to study. Along with the religious philosophical studies, physical education was given due emphasis and was taught to the students in a systematic manner. Here also, pranayama and Surya Namaskar were forms of physical exercise practiced by the students. Now the Rajput period. The Rajputs, called them pure Kshatriyas, and their by profession, by birth, was fighting. Horse riding, javelin throwing, archery, wrestling, hunting and maze fighting, etc. were very, very popular physical activities. In this period, girls were also taught how to ride a horse without saddle. Dancing and music were also part of the activities during the Rajput period. We come to the Muslim period. In this period, many traditional activities like yoga and pranayama were given a setback. Hunting seems to be a very, very popular sport of this period. Sports like wrestling, boxing, swimming, sword fighting and javelin throwing were given emphasis. Pigeon flying and animal fighting were also very popular as sport as well as recreational activities. The British period. Physical education had always existed in the Indian society in one form or the other. In 1833, Government of India shouldered the responsibility of education, and in 1870, education was made a state subject. For the first time, the Indian Education Commission in 1882 recommended physical training in school education. It recommended that physical training be promoted in schools in the interest of the youth by encouragement of native games. Gymnastics, drills and other exercises were interested in the school. Some private organizations for physical education like gymnasia, vyayamshala, akharas, krida mandals contributed much for the spread of the traditional interest in the matter. Dans, baithaks, yogic exercise, folk dancing, wrestling and exercises with light apparatus received greater attention. Indigenous games like kho-kho and atyapatya also became very popular during this period. The physical education such as drills and PT exercises were imparted in some schools by ex-servicemen re-employed by the school authorities. The scientific physical education in pre-independent India goes to the YMCA College of Physical Education, Madras, founded in 1920 by H.C. Buck. In 1931, the Government College of Physical Education came in Hyderabad. Friends, you have just learned historical development of physical education in the part 1 of this series. In the part 2 of the series, we will talk about the development of yoga. Namaskar.